Can we? Oh, thank you very much. All right, good evening. Good evening to you and good evening to our Polish friends and our Israeli friends watching online. And before we continue, let's give a big hand, a big round of applause to Guy Rintus Trio that was here. Yes, and to Hila Kulik and Adar Neuberg. Yes. They both did such a fantastic job in taking this already enchanted and amazing and immortal material to... It was such a trip. And yes, and they deserve that. And it was a pleasure to listen backstage. And before I play my set, I thought I'd share some things with you. Well, like all of us, I take the liberty of saying all of us, I've been in love with the music of Chopin, well, ever since I can remember, and ever since I was introduced to it by my mother first, and then by my classical teacher, Rachel Feinstein, who I hope is watching. And yes, he is a genius. And I thought a lot of what would be the right way to go about this, and respecting the classical tradition, Chopin's tradition, the jazz tradition, and being true to myself. How do I make this as authentic as I can? And I came to the conclusion that the fun thing to do, and also the right thing for me to do, would be to play first the Chopin original intact as it was written, and then my own version, back to back, so that maybe you'd get a glimpse to the way things are happening and the improvisation happens, because Chopin was also a great improviser, and you can tell by his music. And I thought I'd start with an etude, his ninth etude, opus 10, number 9 in F minor. And the important thing to know, and that's the last you're going to hear from me for quite a while, is that Chopin's etudes are not only a technical challenge, and they are very demanding, but they are etudes for the soul. So, etude for the soul in F minor.
Thank you.
Thank you all very much. Thank you. That was the Etude in F minor, number 9. Now from the second opus of the Etudes, this is Etude number 13, or opus 25, number 1. It's often entitled The Harp, or the Aeolian Harp Etude. And hopefully, if I get this right, you'll understand why.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Two numbers to go. And we're very lucky to have that next number, actually, because Chopin was his own worst critic. And he died. It was a tragic death at the age of 39. He died at 1849 from a terrible disease. And he ordered to burn, after his death, all the compositions that didn't see light, that didn't weren't published in his life because he didn't deem him worthy enough. And lucky for us that they didn't listen to him, and we have the posthumous compositions, because we would have lost such amazing rare gems, such as the Fantasy Impromptu.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. And before the last number, the last composition, I'd just like to thank again the Polish Institute and the Keilat HaJazz HaHevratit, the Israeli Jazz Society, and Barak Weiss, and all the people that were involved, the sound and the photographers, everything, and you for being a part of this amazing thing. And of course, again, like Guy Mintus so rightfully did to Frédéric Chopin, who deserves the biggest round of applause. And yes. And the last number is, I remembered reading a biography of Chopin and in one of the books about him anyway. It was mentioned that there was actually an American standard from the 20s or just before the 20s entitled I'm Always Chasing Rainbows. And its melody is based on the middle part. I'm always chasing rainbows. Pardon my horrible singing voice, but just so you get the idea. Anyway, I thought it would be fun and appropriate to end with this, the Chopin Jazz Tribute, the standard that's based on the melody you just heard. I'm always chasing rainbows. Thank you.
Thank you.